Hello everyone, this is Haji Dalwal. Welcome to Tackling Tech. Microsoft Ignite is amazing for many, many reasons. One of the things that I'm really excited about is that my team has worked with several individuals, several organizations to bring students from the local community to experience what Microsoft Ignite is all about, what Microsoft is all about, and about our products and services. Joining me are two amazing people who work with this program and who has brought these students with us. Welcome to the show, and please introduce yourself.
Sure. Hello, my name is Areli Dorsey. I am the Director of Workforce Development for IC Stars Chicago. A little bit of what I do is that we are training young professionals who are looking to launch careers in technology. So I work with all of our external corporate partners to find good opportunities for them to work in technology.
Fantastic.
Thank you for the opportunity. I'm Nisaini Rexach, and I work at Microsoft Philanthropies. I have the opportunity to manage one of our funding portfolios for what we invest in, and that is my direct connection to IC Stars. They are a current grantee and beneficiary of our organization.
Amazing. Both amazing, amazing, very important roles and connections here. So I've been around the conference center and stuff like that. I've seen a bunch of students wearing similar, blue jackets and things like that. And I had an opportunity to sit down and have lunch with them and whatnot. So can you tell us, what is IC Stars, first of all?
Absolutely. So IC Stars is a training program for young adults who are looking for an opportunity but haven't had access to an opportunity. Perhaps they couldn't afford college, perhaps they just were never shown a pathway. So IC Stars finds those individuals, we train them in technology, whether that's to be a coder, software development, whether that's going into project management or IT support roles, anything that is going to launch them into a potential pathway towards success in technology. So we train them, and then we find opportunities in the tech community for them to work.
All right. So how are you finding these students, and how are they finding you?
There's a lot of different channels we use for marketing. I would say our greatest advocate is our alumni group. So we've been around for 25 years. We're celebrating 25 years through a technology prom in a few weeks. And so our alumni have spread the word. We actually have an alumni who's been at Microsoft as an employee for 23 years. He was one of the first people to go through our program. So our alumni really do promote us and get us recruits, but we also promote through LinkedIn and other avenues, billboards, things of that nature.
Yeah, and you're probably also working with other organizations.
Absolutely.
That, are giving them this information to come and connect with you, and right?
Correct.
It's very clear that there's a mentor and mentee, system going here with the alumni and stuff like that.
Yes.
So what about you? You're from Microsoft. You're doing philanthropy. How are you working with these amazing organizations?
Yes. Well, I had a first in my professional career. I got to work with a former employer. I previously was at IC Stars. I was the director of programming and got to train and help develop and position the participants to be ready to hand over to Areli, who then does workforce development with our actual employment partners at that time to ensure our participants were placed. So it is a very sweet delight to be able to now work with her in a new capacity and IC Stars as an organization, because they are a part of my funding portfolio, because that nonprofit is one of our beneficiaries. And that amazing Microsoft employee that Areli referenced, Kevin Gates, no affiliation to Bill, so we're clear, is how I got my start at Microsoft. He saw what I brought to the table and said, I think you can sort of scale your missional impact to help others. And that's how I got to Microsoft.
That's awesome. So these students that were here, how did that come about? And what was the plan? What was the end result here that we're trying?
Yes, through a colleague internally at Microsoft, I was introduced to Lior, who is a part of the Windows endpoint team. Lior got to come and observe the circuit program. The circuit program is a summer program, but it is positioned for high school juniors and seniors. We had an initial thought that a great community engagement activation for Ignite would be for the circuit students to come and see, especially the seniors. Due to compliance and age restrictions, we pivoted, but I do think things happen very serendipitously as they should, and that gave IC Stars and our other organizational partner was Think Chicago, through World Business Chicago here in the city. That's how we pivoted to the two student groups that we now had.
Yeah, I did meet with some of the students. I had like really deep conversations with them. All have different backgrounds, different experiences, different takes in life and stuff like that, right? And career paths that they want to go into.
Yes. And so between Lior and Julie putting their heads together on what the Windows Endpoint team could do, that resulted in us being able to bring and sponsor a 20 participant group size to really harness the power of Ignite and not let cost be a barrier to entry. Microsoft Philanthropies really positions itself to provide opportunities for those typically excluded from the digital economy. And these two organizations are directly serving participants that fall into that area of focus.
So what are you hearing from these students that have been here for a few days now? Mm-hmm. You know, what are they like, what are they so excited about? You know, I'm sure they are like, wow, you know, they were at the keynote, right? Yeah. They had really good seats. They saw Satya Nadella firsthand. So tell me about that excitement.
I think there's a plethora of things that they've already expressed, they've been excited about. I think what stands out the most is the opportunity to meet individuals. Similar to what Nisaini was saying, a lot of them just don't have access to certain groups, certain professional organizations. So networking has been instrumental in, I think, their process here. Additionally, having exposure to Microsoft products and seeing sort of the inside scoop, I think they're very excited about. Yesterday at the keynote, Satya gave so much intel. And yes. So to be there firsthand and saying like, we're releasing this and this is something that we're excited about, I think the exclusive nature of the conference really helps our participants to feel connected and involved and learn something they may not otherwise have access to.
And there's so many professionals here, right? Experts, things like that. I helped introduce one to a developer because he wants to go into, you know, software development.
Thank you for that.
Right. So, but these are the connections you make, right? You're trying to help them, give them the path. It's wonderful to see. They are our future leaders.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
This is what we are calling them, right? Future leaders. And they're going to do some amazing things. They're going to enhance the technologies that we have now. So, you know, the world is their oyster. So are there any takeaways that you want or anything you want to share about whether it's your program, about community service? You know, this is your platform.
I would just underscore the importance of companies like Microsoft creating space and a runway for those that would typically not have a seat at the table to experience opportunities like Ignite and or comparable. It was really rewarding to see our participant group have organic conversations with attendees to really sort of take in what the impact of generative AI will have on the marketplace and society overall. And I was very thrilled to be a part of this. And the way that I described it yesterday when I got home to my husband was, this was such a productive grind. It was very refreshing and rewarding, and it is something that I hope other teams outside of Windows would consider doing at the company, at Microsoft, for future experiences, maybe even build for other participant and nonprofits groups in the host city to experience.
Yeah, and I would similarly say, she kind of stole what I was going to say, make sure, like, as a leader in the tech community, that you're thinking about those who maybe don't have access in multiple ways, right? Like, Ignite is just one opportunity to open the door a bit to folks from non-traditional backgrounds. But also, like, I wouldn't be me if I didn't talk about our talent at IC Stars. So everything about what we do is producing talent. of course, it's a group that doesn't traditionally have access. So just because we give them the training, that doesn't mean the doors are open for them to get the opportunities. And so similar to what Nisaini is saying, like being mindful of who those folks are and understanding that a lot is missed by not accessing those talent pipelines, because those are people who are incredibly resilient. They're problem solvers. They're hustlers. Yes. They really want an opportunity. All they need is a door and then consistent investment. So training and mentorship. So I have to mention, if you're looking for entry-level junior talent, grinders, hustlers, people who want to work for your company and grow and are loyal, we have folks within IC Stars.
Talent is everywhere, but opportunity is not.
Yes.
And this is just a really great example of giving folks the opportunity to build their brand and build social currency.
Yep.
So that their brand being in the room can be positive to help aid in where they're trying to end up in their technological careers.
Yeah, all of them are asking for an opportunity. Just talk to me. Just give me a chance to show you my worth, right? That's all that they want. And they can do a lot of things. One of your students yesterday said, you know, we talked about, you know, reach out, ask, network, things like that. And he said, you know, it's like a saying, you know, if you keep your mouth closed, you're not going to get fed, kind of a thing, right?
Absolutely.
So I've been hearing so many amazing things from these students. The one thing I've got to give you guys props, both of you and everybody else who's been involved with this, these 20 students, the diversity of the students that you guys brought. Mm-hmm. I am so focused on diversity and inclusion in a good way, right? Because we can talk about it. People say they do it, you know, they dot their T's and I's, kind of a thing. But you guys truly, we have from different backgrounds, different ethnicities, women, men, you know, everything. It's just fantastic. Please keep doing that. It's great.
Thank you.
Yeah, I love that you brought that up, just because diversity means so many different things. And I think oftentimes people put it in a box and it's like, no, we need diversity of thought. We need diversity of all different things. So I think people from IC Stars have that. And I also wanted to underscore and just say thank you to Microsoft and the Windows and Endpoint team and Nisaini for putting this together for us. It's an opportunity of a lifetime, really. As we know, this conference wasn't here. It's been like 10 years since it's been here or something.
Yeah.
So having the opportunity has been great. And also human connection is everything. Yeah. The connection just between Nisaini and I, it really allows us to leverage these opportunities. So if nothing else, like, we're encouraging our participants to connect with people, build those relationships.
Yes. So we're going to do bigger and better things for the next time. So stay tuned.
We're going to hold you to that.
Thank you for having us.
Will.
We appreciate it.
Yeah, I really appreciate it. Thank you for being on the show and sharing your thoughts and stuff like that. And thank you for sharing your students.
Yes. Thank you for the opportunity.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for watching Tech and Tech. I hope you enjoyed this episode and learned something new. Stay tuned for the next episode, where we're going to talk to these students who are our future leaders and to learn more.